और अगली बड़ी खबर जिस पर हम सुबह से ही बने हुए हैं, 1993 मुंबई बम हमले में दोषी पाए गए याकूब मेमन को फांसी का रास्ता साफ हो चुका है। टाडा कोर्ट ने याकूब मेमन के खिलाफ डेथ वारंट जारी किया है। अगर याकूब की पुनरीक्षण याचिका खारिज हो गई तो इस महीने के आखिर में नागपुर जेल में याकूब को फांसी हो सकती है। तब तक आपको यह भी बता दें कि अगर याकूब को फांसी हुई तो 1993 बम हमले का वो पहला मुजरिम होगा जो फांसी पर लटकेगा। 93 धमाकों का आरोपी और इन धमाकों में लगभग 270 लोगों की जान गई थी और 700 से भी ज्यादा लोग घायल हुए थे। याकूब मेमन का अगस्त 1994 का एक इंटरव्यू अब हम आपको दिखाएंगे, किस तरह से उसने अपने ऊपर लगे आरोपों पर सफाई पेश की थी वो सुनिए।
Who was the brain behind?
Brain was Pakistan government. ISI what they call.
Mm-hmm. And what did they do?
They supplied arms, explosives.
Who told you?
Tawfiq Jallianwala told me this.
That the Pakistan
Yes, that
ISI...
he used to boast then. Mm. I have done a very good job. That this way we had planned everything and we dictated.
What did he say? What did Tawfiq Jallianwala say to you?
Tawfiq Jallianwala told
me. About the bomb blast?
Yes, about the bomb blast.
What did he say?
That I have supplied the arms, explosives and I have dictated the spots, you know. Because Tiger, I had given the work to execute. Tiger with his boys have executed the blast and I had done everything. Been supplying of arms, explosives, and dictating the spots. Pakistan did what they wanted.
What did they want?
Taking
what
the
did
name
Pakistan
of,
want?
See, Pakistan wants to create trouble in India. And to do all those things which harms government of India and people of government, people of India, be it a Muslim or a Hindu. It is not their concern. They are just interested in creating trouble in India. They saw the situation in January riots that Muslims have a bit
so
of
they
feeling.
Saw this.
Whenever Pakistan will get this type of occasion, they will definitely give trouble to our country. Definitely. If they will get a chance to slap even one of our person, they will do that. They are up to this. And they are appealing the international, they are seeking support from international Muslims that our Muslim brothers in India are being tortured. Association is done to them, and this way they are taking sympathy from them.
Do you know Javed Chikna?
I've heard his name. He's also in Pakistan.
And Ijaz Pathan?
Ijaz Pathan is also in Pakistan.
Did they go with you?
No.
You met them there?
No, I haven't met them. I had just information about their whereabouts and...
What information? How did you get it?
I got from this Tiger's driver. Shafi, who became a, you know, I developed friendship with him to go get all the information from him.
And these two men are still there?
Yes, yes, they are there.
And they're also rehabilitated by
Yes, they are rehabilitated by Tawfiq.
They also have,
Pakistani passports,
identities.
They have identity cards, they stay in a flat over there. In fact, some of the boys are staying at Tawfiq's bungalow.
Some
at
of the
Rufi
boys
Cottage.
Meaning, who are
means, I don't remember their names, you know, some Teda Meda, some names are there, Yaqub Beda. Dawood Ibrahim, according to Tawfiq, he's there.
He is in Pakistan.
I have never met him. He's in Pakistan.
You have never met him in your life?
Never in my life. Never in my life. On 17th, we have boarded a PIA flight. It was to land at Dubai via Karachi. But we were escorted by a Pakistani agent at Karachi airport without any immigration and formality. We were escorted out of the Qaid-e Azam airport, Karachi airport.
By Pakistani agent? You mean whom?
Asif, his name was. He was a bald fellow. He escorted us right from inside the airport to outside.
And your passports, were they stamped?
No, no formalities of any immigration or customs were completed.
A Pakistani official came, took you off the flight, and took you without any formalities
right,
through.
Right.
And your passports were given to him? But did you give him your Indian passport?
Yes, he collected our Indian passport. The very first thing he did, he collected our Indian passport. He escorted us outside the airport then, without any formality.
You did not have your your Indian passport with you then?
Yes, since then, after 1 year, we received our Indian passports.
Where were you taken then, by Asif?
From there, from airport, we were taken to one Tofik Jallianwala's bungalow in Karachi. It is in Duraji Colony.
And you stayed there?
Yeah, we stayed there.
The whole family?
Not whole family, because on 17th, myself, my wife, father, mother and younger brothers had shifted there. By 20 or 21st, rest of the members joined us at the same place in the bungalow. Taken to Bangkok on 17th April. Those was the time, you know, I had realized what has happened. Before that, neither myself nor any member of the family had the slightest, you know, inkling about all these things. But when, after
all
reaching,
what things?
Is this bomb blast and the conspiracy behind this.
Mm-hmm. So you got to know about it in Bangkok?
Not in Bangkok, after reaching Karachi.
I see. And when you went to Bangkok, who accompanied you?
Bangkok, we Captain Sarwar, his name was, alias Usman. He was a government official. He accompanied
Pakistani government?
Yes, a Pakistani government official.
What was his name?
He used to tell Usman, but later I came to know that his name is Captain Sarwar.
Where did you stay in Bangkok?
Bangkok, we were taken to a bungalow at some Pattaya Road. And there we were confined to a house. We didn't move anywhere. They
you
used
didn't
to serve.
Stay in a hotel?
On 16, some of the members had gone. They stayed in Hotel Indira Regency. Mm-hmm. I went on 17, we joined them. And then we were taken to a bungalow at Pattaya Road. There we stayed for around up to 29th April.
What picked up your expenses in Bangkok?
I think these Pakistani officials. After that, Tofik and Tiger had arranged a plot of land for a new house at Karachi Development Scheme.
How many, what was the size of it?
It was 1,000 yards, a very spacious plot was there.
How much did you pay for it?
Around 60 lakhs rupees.
60 lakhs?
Yes.
And who paid for it?
Tiger. Tiger and Tofik used to pay. All the funds was given by Tiger and Tofik.
याकूब मेमन इस पूरे मामले में दोषी पाया गया और उसके बाद फांसी की सजा उसे सुनाई गई. अब टाडा की विशेष अदालत ने डेथ वारंट भी जारी कर दिया है याकूब मेमन के खिलाफ. नागपुर की जेल में 30 जुलाई को सुबह 7 बजे याकूब मेमन को फांसी दी जाएगी. मेमन को काठमांडू एयरपोर्ट पर पकड़ा गया था. पेशे से चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट, 1994 में नेपाल पुलिस और इंटरपोल ने पकड़ा. काठमांडू एयरपोर्ट पर कई पासपोर्ट बरामद किए गए. उसके पास से तलाशी में वीडियो और ऑडियो टेप भी बरामद किया गया जिससे कई अहम सबूत मिले. नेपाल पुलिस ने सीबीआई को याकूब को सौंपा. क्या कुछ आरोप है याकूब मेमन पर वो दिखाते हैं आपको. मुंबई ब्लास्ट के लिए आर्थिक मदद की, यानी कि हर तरीके से पैसा पहुंचाया. ब्लास्ट के बाद आरोपी को फरार कराने में याकूब मेमन ने मदद की. आरोपियों के लिए एयर के टिकट मुहैया कराए, यानी कि उन्हें भगाने में भी मदद करी. ब्लास्ट में इस्तेमाल गाड़ियों को खरीदा. बम लगी गाड़ियों को प्लांट किया. कहां पर ये गाड़ियां खड़ी होंगी पूरी प्लानिंग याकूब मेमन ने की ताकि ज्यादा से ज्यादा नुकसान हो सके.